Hi everyone, welcome back here to the channel. In today's video, I'm going to explain to you how you can become the executor of a deceased estate. Now guys, just a few things to keep in mind as we go through this. Firstly, it is only the Master of the High Court that can appoint an executor to a deceased estate. So you'll be applying to the Master to be appointed as executor. Secondly, applying to be appointed as an executor normally forms part of the process of reporting the estate to the Master as well. Now, in this video, we are not going to deal with the reporting requirements for deceased estate. We are only focused on what you need to do to be appointed as an executor to the estate. Finally, to keep in mind, depending on the situation, the Master will have different requirements before appointing you as an executor to the estate. So let's look at each of these circumstances. The first possibility is this. You want to be the executor of the estate. The deceased who died left the will, and in the will, you are nominated as the executor of the estate. Now, if that's the case, guys, all you need to do is you need to provide the Master with a completed and signed document called the acceptance of trust as executor. It's basically the formal document in terms of which you accept your nomination. And then you also need to provide the Master with two certified copies of your ID. That's it. The Master will appoint you. The second scenario is you want to be the executor of the estate, but the deceased did not leave a will where you are nominated to be the executor. Now, guys, if that is your situation, then what you need is you still need the acceptance of trust as executor, completed and signed in duplicate. And then you still need two times your certified copies of your ID. But now you also need a written formal nomination letter signed by all of the heirs of the estate that nominates you to be the executor of that estate. The third scenario you might be in is you want to be the executor of the estate. The deceased died. The deceased did leave a will, but in the will, someone else is nominated to act as the executor. So what do you do now? Now, guys, if that's your situation, you still need your formal acceptance of trust as executor, completed and signed in duplicate. You still need two times certified copies of your ID. You will still need the heirs to nominate you formally in writing to act as the executor. But now you also need the executor that's been nominated in the will. You need a formal renunciation of the nomination from that person. The renunciation is basically the person saying they do not accept the nomination as executor as per the will. So guys, just a final thing to also keep in mind, you may also have to give the Master a bond of security before the Master appoints you as the executor of the estate. Now, basically, a bond of security will be required if you are not otherwise exempted from putting up security. Normally, you are exempted from putting up security if the terms of the will that nominates you, if in the will you are exempted from the need to put up security, or you can also be exempted if you are applying to be the executor and you are the parent, spouse, or the child of the deceased. Now, guys, that's it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you found some value in it. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you back here next time. And until then, take care and cheers for now.